So the growing of crops requires nitrogen and phosphorus, which, as we know, really helps things to grow. And unfortunately, there are places where we don't want things to grow. We don't want algae blooms to grow so rapidly and, in many cases, dangerously in our lakes. So can we keep nitrogen and phosphorus on the fields? That's where we need them. That's where the crops need them. There's a growing community of farmers that are interested in furthering their stewardship of land. But the big gap that we're seeing is the challenge of transition. It requires new knowledge, sometimes new equipment. We have been working with farmers to better understand what would help them to make that transition a little bit easier. And so our work with the New York Outcomes Fund is focused on taking those additional steps and implementing and adopting the additional practices that have a positive benefit for the Great Lakes, but also for the farmers themselves who would actually implement these solutions.
If we didn't have cover crops here, this would just be pretty much a chunk of dirt with no living roots in it. And this is just, in my opinion, doing great things for that soil. That is awful lot of roots for one little shovel full of soil. So cover crop grows in the fall. In theory, it gets enough root system. It's gonna hold the soil if you get a big water event, wind event. And in theory, after years, and it's now come true on our farm, the more we've done it, the better our soil gets. So you can withstand dry years, wet years. It just seems to make your soil a little more resilient. And every year we do it, we're just more sold on the practice. So the Outcomes Fund's just been a good fit for us. It's really been a catalyst to get us to pretty much put cover crop on all our acres.
So here's how it works. We pay farmers upfront 50%. For the estimated carbon emission reductions we expect to see through the adoption of these practices, as well as the lower nitrogen and phosphorus reductions. We then work with third-party evaluators to look at the farmer's data, to validate the data, and verify by going out and visiting all of these fields. After visiting these fields, we go back to the farmer and we share with them the other 50% if they have complied with the practices that we imagined they would be implementing.
It is one of the simplest programs I've ever been enrolled in. And we're all too busy, so it just makes life easy that they come to our farm, look at things over, and we signed up. This is the second year we've done it, and we've just been so amazed that there is no strings attached. It's really a well-run program.
From the very beginning, our work has focused on inviting public and private sector stakeholders into the conversation to help us understand what might we be missing from the perspective of a university. And that work has been central to the mission of Cornell Atkinson. How do we find external strategic partnerships? And when we saw traction, when we saw that there was this really exciting desire to be part of this program, we started to engage private sector funders to see if not only could we generate these outcomes, but would somebody buy the outcomes. In our case, we partnered with Cargill, and so they agreed to pre-purchase any carbon and water quality outcomes that we could produce during the pilot. And so it's been a central part of the work that we're doing is to involve the private sector in the work, both for the funding, but also for the potential of replication or scaling the work after the pilot ends. What I'm really, excited about is that we're seeing farmers who have used the program to try these practices and are coming back every year. In these last 2 years, they're coming back and saying, we want to do more. We want to do more. I would say 99% of the farmers we're working with are coming back and saying, can we enroll more? And more than that, they've also said, even if you don't pay us, we're going to do more of this. On the fields that we can't enroll, we're going to adopt these practices. So it really leans into the mission of Cornell Atkinson of trying to move research into action. through this work, the farmers that we've been working with have shown me that they are really making a difference in their communities. They've also shown us that as we join with them through world-class research and world-class engagement, together we can make the world so much better.